Hello and welcome to this introduction to the Omega Platinum Series controller software. Chances are, if you're watching this video, it means that you have an Omega Platinum Series controller. Maybe you've programmed it using the front panel switches, but you're looking for an easier way to program it using your computer. Well then, Omega's Platinum Series configuration software for CNPT controllers is what you've been looking for. If you haven't downloaded the software yet, you can find it at www.omega.com/software and look for Platinum Software for CNPT Series. But for now, we'll assume that you have the software and you're ready to get programming, so let's get started. First, connect the controller to your computer. You can connect via Ethernet, USB, or using a serial port. For this video, we'll just use the USB port, which is the simplest way to connect. If you want to connect via Ethernet or serial port, there's a link in the description of this video that will take you to a quick setup guide that covers those types of connections. Once you've connected your controller via USB, you can launch the Platinum Series controller software. First, you'll be greeted with the communication setup window. This is where you can select your connection type, communication protocol, COM port, and address. You'll notice here in the port pull-down, we can see our device listed as COM3, which means that our controller has been recognized by the computer. Now we'll just click the Connect button, and that takes us to the Platinum Monitor window. First, you'll notice that the temperature reading is the same as what is displayed on the front panel of your controller. You've got two set points that can be assigned from the Set Point button located here in the Configuration Group area. For your process input, you can select your input type, either thermocouple, RTD, process, or thermistor. In PID control, you can set up PID 1 and PID 2 for two different control loops. That's handy if you're setting up a heating or cooling process. Next, we have the annunciators. These are triggers that you can set whenever you want to either sound an alarm or to throw a switch to perform an action. Use the auxiliary input window to configure a remote set point. The alarms window is where you can set your alarm mode to off, above, below, high, low, and band. Then moving right along, you can set your alarm limits here. If you want to take advantage of the Platinum Series controller's three-color LED display, you can set your alarm color here. Once you've made the desired changes to these parameters, click on the Update button and your settings will be saved. In the Outputs window, you can select the type of output you want to assign each of your output channels. You can choose On, Off, Alarm, Ramp On, Soak On, and so forth. The Display, Safety, and Excitation buttons will all take you to the same window where you can set their parameters. For example, display settings are where you can change the decimal points to best match the range that your sensor is operating at. The units pull-down is where you can change the units of measurement from Celsius to Fahrenheit, adjust your display color, brightness, and time format. In the excitation pull-down, you can adjust your excitation voltage. Under safety, you can adjust the safety parameters. Now if we click on the graphing button, this will open the data charting window. This is where you can begin recording data. For instance, I have a load cell that I'm applying pressure to. You can see the variations in the value as the chart records. To save this data, I click on the Save button and then name the file to give it a destination. Or I can click on Clear and start the data logging all over again. In the configuration window, we can choose what model we're using, controller or meter. Under Communications, we can choose Serial or Ethernet. Here's where you can upgrade the firmware for your device. If we return to the Platinum Monitor window, in the lower right corner is the refresh area. Here you can set the refresh timer. I'll set this to refresh automatically every 1 second. That about wraps up our introduction to Omega's Platinum Series software. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and check out our other videos. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to helping you sense incredible things.